Hello. I am Professor Yuki, and today on Technically You Quick Bites, we are covering Virtual Private LAN Services, VPLS. What is Virtual Private LAN Services, VPLS? Virtual Private LAN Service is a protocol with which you can build a secured virtual multipoint-to-multipoint Ethernet network over an IP multiprotocol label switching, MPLS network. VPLS technology allows local area networks to be interconnected and appear as a single Ethernet LAN. This allows geographically dispersed sites to share a single broadcast domain using pseudowires. Some reference of VPLS as a flat network since it operates as an any-to-any meshed local area network. One difference between VPLS and MPLS is VPLS is a multipoint network that allows the customer control of all routings versus the codependent routing between carrier and customer with MPLS. By the way, if you want to know more about MPLS, Technically You covers it in a separate video. VPLS networks are preferred over other types of networks due to its extremely low latency and ease of management. Since we happen to touch on pseudowire in this session, we might as well provide you with a brief definition. What is a pseudowire? A pseudowire is an industry term for transport of any frames over an MPLS network using MPLS to encapsulate an LDP, label distribution protocol, as a signaling mechanism. Pseudowires can be used to deliver two types of services to end users, Virtual Private Wire Service, VPWS, and Virtual Private LAN Service, VPLS. With VPWS, the provider delivers the virtual equivalent of a leased line, where the customer is responsible for managing the IP routing. If there are disparate transport types, internet working must be done at the provider edge, PE, to translate the layer 2 frames from one transport type to another. As we discussed in the last paragraph, with VPLS, different sites can share an Ethernet broadcast domain using pseudowires, providing any-to-any connectivity. VPLS may be used to connect to data centers, storage area networks, contact centers, and media centers. It supports latency-sensitive applications like voice over IP and video broadcasting. It can be used to transport non-IP applications without the need for protocol conversion and encapsulation, and allows for easy separation of private networking or private application domains. Since VPLS does not allow carrier visibility and gives the user complete control of the network, it is considered quite secured for compliance and regulatory requirements. Benefits of VPLS: lower latency, fast, secure, and homogeneous network. Ease of well-known Ethernet protocol. Handles multiple protocols. Concerns with VPLS: customer manages their own network, not the carrier. Challenging to manage with large numbers of MAC addresses, since there is no hierarchy, like IP addresses. Not as scalable to large numbers of locations. In closing, Virtual Private LAN Service is an Ethernet-based multipoint any-to-any communication method over an IP or MPLS network. VPLS allows you locations to have the look and feel as if you are operating in the same office and on the same network, no matter the location or distance. VPLS provides low latency, security, a high level of performance, is protocol agnostic, and is a very cost-effective network service. Thank you for watching today's video. We really appreciate you spending time with us. Please subscribe to our channel if you find this or any other Technically You video topics interesting.